Welcome to our channel, The Child. Today, we are going to show you a new activity in the arena of exercises of practical life, which is nothing but those activities which we can see in our daily life. Today, we are going to show you how to pour liquids. The liquids we have chosen is water. For this activity, you need a tray, a jug and 3 cups or glasses of equal size, and you can see the functional decoration, the red markings, which is an indicator which we will explain while doing the activity. First, let's invite the child by saying that, "Child, shall I show you how to pour water?" And make the child to sit next to you. Make sure the child is sitting on your left. Then you can say a statement saying that, "Watch carefully, I'm going to show you how to pour water." Now let's start the activity. We keep such that, or we place the glasses and jug such that they're not making any noise. We need a wiping cloth as well. Keep the tray aside. Now, show the child those red markings and say that, "Child, stop me when the water reaches this mark." So this way, we grab the attention of the child. Here, the jug is filled with water already, but at home, you can ask the child to go and get the water till that red markings, which we call it as functional decoration, which is nothing but an indicator. Now let's start the activity. Watch carefully. Child will say stop. Then we can say thank you. Now, we can ask the child, did I spill any water? The child observes carefully and say, no. So, and this is why we need to show a presentation perfectly. So, when we try our best to show a presentation perfectly, the child will try his or her best to do in the same way. Now, we can ask the child, would you like to repeat now? The child say, yes. Then we have to transfer the water back into the jug. Before that, if you notice here, we have transferred or we poured the water into three equal glasses, right? So, and also you can notice that there is leftover. You can see the water remaining in the jug. Can you guess what operation does it signify? Yes, you are right. Division. Distributing or sharing equally into three cups or glasses. And whatever leftover, whatever is there remaining in the jug is nothing but reminder. Whatever Montessori has given, there is always an inner significance. And if you have a question, why three cups or why three glasses has been selected? You are right. She felt that number three is not too much or too less. To start with, even you can show to your child to transfer 1:1. From jug to one cup, or even one jug to two, 1:2. Later, you can also show 1:3. So this way, we are making the child prepared for complex activities from simple things. These activities refines the hand movements of children. The more they use their hands, they are ready for writing. And also, by showing these activities, they understand what is perfection. By showing them without spilling and how we place these glasses, everything you would have noticed, we strive for perfection. We try to show our best. Now we can ask the child, would you like to repeat? The child has to repeat. We have to pour the water back into the jug. And we have to wait so that the last drop of water drips off. If you observe, we pour it back quickly. Whereas in the previous activity where we showed transferring grains, it's a slow activity. We transfer very slowly, very gradually, so that it gets filled up in a jug or in a glass, so that whatever the grains we are pouring, it will be in an equal, the grains filled up, leveled up. Here, there is no necessity, so it's a quick movement. For grains, we transfer it slowly so that the grains gets filled up in the same level. So that is why first we show pouring or transferring grains first, and then we show pouring liquids. First we show transferring solids or grains, and next we show pouring water. Now the space is ready for the child to start the activity. In case if the child doesn't show any interest, we can always show the child how to wind up. Here we will show how to wind up the same material. So I hope you like this activity. Please share your comments, and if you like these activities, please share with your friends and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.